Hello, this time I will show you how to make a visually beautiful spectrum analyzer that can also function as an audiovometer and waterfall analyzer. At the back there is a small switch through which we can choose whether the matrix will run via the line input or via a microphone. When you use a line input, the incoming stereo signal is first converted to a mono using a 210 kilo ohms resistors, then through a 100 nanofarad capacitor to block the DC. The signal is then biased by two 100 kilo ohm resistors to 1.65 volts to be read by the analog to digital converter. Using the microphone board is a much simpler than the line in method, but you will be limited to the frequencies that you can detect by the sensitivity of the microphone. The matrix is controlled from a single button. There are 5 modes of operation, 3 of which are spectral analyzers, 1 audiometer and 1 waterfall analyzer. The functions of the button are as follows. Single press change the pattern. Long press change the brightness. 3 button presses in 2 seconds set to auto change pattern, like in this case. 5 button presses in 2 seconds turn off the display. I made the project on a ready-made 16x16 matrix, which simplifies the way of making, and then I also made a very small adjustments to the code for this case, and you can download it below. As I said before, the device is a simple to make and contains a several components. ESP32 microcontroller board, 16x16 WS2812 LED matrix, next small microphone board which contains a preamplifier chip, 5 resistors, 1 capacitor and 1 button. If you want the device to look identical like this, then you also need a 3D printer. To get a better visual effect, the matrix diodes should be separated by partitions. For this purpose, a grid is printed on a 3D printer. I created a custom grid that requires less material and printing time. You can download the STL files at the link below. A tracing paper should be placed over the grid to diffuse the light. And now let's see how the device works and check all the features. This is tracing paper and should be placed over the grid to diffuse the light. This is the grid and this is the LED matrix. During the device description, it was operating in microphone mode. Now when presenting the functions, the matrix will run via the line input. First, we need to plug in an audio signal. We can change the sensitivity in the code depending on the strength of the source signal. By short single button press, we change the patterns. Long press serves to change the brightness. There are 3 levels of brightness. With 3 button presses in 2 seconds, we set device to auto change pattern. And with 5 button presses in 2 seconds, we will turn off the display. And now let's look at an interesting case when we input a sinusoidal signal with a certain frequency, and for that purpose I use this tone generator. As can be seen, this is a spectrum analyzer instrument for a frequency domain analysis. In this way, the device can be used as a simple tool for frequency analysis in the lab, primarily intended for learning. And now let's take a closer look at how the device is made.